Hello, welcome to Literary Life. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you my book reviews for The Literary Journey, Love, and its all its obstacles. So in each of these books, our main characters are trying to overcome some element while maintaining or evolving, developing their romance. Each book is listed below if you are interested in purchasing any. The way my book reviews work is I give every book 1 to 5 stars. 1 star, I did not like the book. 2 stars, the book was okay. 3 stars, it was a good book. I liked it. 4 stars, love the book, great book. And 5 stars are those random, hopefully random books, because they should be really special that just blow my mind. So let's get started. The first book, you guys, I am so excited. Because if you know me, you know romance is not an easy genre for me. I have a really hard time with it, and I actually really enjoyed this. And it was People We Meet on Vacation by Emily Henry. This was a 4-star read for me. So our main characters have been taking a vacation every year together for a long time. They have been friends for a really long time. And all of a sudden, on one of these vacations, something happened, and 2 years have passed and they have not talked. And there is an opportunity, and our one main character, she reaches out to him, her previous best friend, and to resume a vacation, and then on that vacation to hopefully come to terms with everything that went on between them and resolve that. I love the fact, first of all, guys, the characters I thought were fun. They were each very distinct, very different. We get to go back in time and hear about how they met in college, how their friendship evolved. It's one of those just unlikely friendships where they are such opposites, but they balance each other out beautifully, and I love that component. I love the fact that we get to follow them forward out of college into their adult lives. And continue to see the way their friendship is sustained despite the differences in their personalities and lives. And then, of course, the romantic component to it, as that is played out, I thought was very fun, and I thoroughly enjoyed this book. So great characters. I love the setting because they do travel, so you get to experience a little bit of these different locations. And then just a fun, I think, coming of age book. So for those of you that are like me and romance isn't your go-to genre, but sometimes you're like, I need something a little light and fun, I thought this was a great book, People We Meet on Vacation. So the next 4-star read in this case, it's not friendship that's the obstacle, but it's actually marriage to other people. So 28 Summers by Ellen Hildebrand. So this particular book, our main character is a woman who is actually passing due to a pretty aggressive form of cancer. On her deathbed, she passes to her son, her adult son, or tells him to go open this envelope. And in that envelope is a man's name and phone number. And lo and behold, this man is politically well known because he is married to one of the top presidential candidates that are currently in the running. One of the things this book does, so basically we have a situation where our main character, her and this man, have for 28 years had that one weekend together. And have maintained this relationship again since college, but despite the fact that he obviously has gone on to marry, his wife is obviously in the political field, very public sector. So their relationship has been kept obviously very secret. But let me tell you, I actually struggled a lot. First, Ellen Hildebrand's writing, the complexity of this type of relationship was really well done. The complexity of the characters, you know, their good and bad traits. All of the characters in the book, in fact, I thought were really well balanced. You get to know a wide group of people. We get to see them over, 28 years, so a long period of time. And I thought that was really, really enjoyable. I'd be so curious for people that have read this book, because of course, I thought such a complex subject like a long-standing affair, and how you can't compare, right, a marriage, a day-to-day relationship with a relationship in which you're literally together, you know, 5 days out of the year, if even. And of course, it's tinged with all of this excitement and novelty and specialness. But so I thought Ellen Hildebrandt did a really good job of kind of like pulling that through. Yep, there was a bond between this couple. There was something, some relationship romance that they kept going. So just the experience of that from start to finish, and then how that existed for each character, the impact it had on their full-time lives, I thought was just beautifully done. So I am not like a huge fan of, I don't know, like adultery sort of books, because I feel like sometimes they're romanticized. But I thought with this one, Ellen Hildebrandt did a really good job of actually bringing to life its complexities in a really realistic way. So this was another 4-star read for me. I absolutely loved it. So the last book that was 4 stars, all 4-star reads in this, was Echoes by Maeve Binchy. So this particular book is set in a small town in Ireland where our main characters have grown up in this village, a female and male, and they are fortunate enough to have gone off to college, the same location in Dublin, in the city, but they come from very different socioeconomic statuses within the village, their families, and that is going to be the obstacle in this book. So essentially, she, our main character, is a brilliant girl who comes from a very poor family who owns like the village like grocery store, all-purpose store. And he comes from a very affluent family. His father is a doctor. His mom is very much a snob. And essentially, they know of each other because all of the kids in the village do. But they also have a few different years between them. He's a couple years older than her. So they've never really socialized. But she is incredibly studious and works very hard and is very fortunate to get a scholarship, not just to secondary school, but then to college. And she just continues on. And that puts her in his path. And they connect and fall in love. And then it causes some tensions in the community. And Maeve Binchy, there's something I have to say, because this is, I think, the third book I've read now by her that, thanks to you all having introduced me to her and talked about her, so I'm picking up all of her books. The beginning for me was very slow. So for those of you, I don't know if you found that when you read this particular book, but I wasn't sure that I was going to like this book. I would say for a good chunk in the beginning. And then I got into the groove. So the way to think about Maeve Binchy's books is you're going to really just become a part of the town, get to know all of the characters. She develops them so thoroughly. You're literally going to get everything brought to life so that when the real core of the plot comes to unfold, you fully feel it. So you have watched the characters grow up well before they have this romantic relationship that is what the summary of the book is about. So it's really cool the way she does that. But I would say this is a slower read. It's a slow build. So this is a good one for when you're ready for that pace. But it is a beautiful story. So well done. And I love the way all of the dynamics and the culture within the village come to play and impact the characters. Maeve Binchy's writing is just stellar, seriously stellar. All right, so that is it for this literary journey review. If you've read these books, as always, I love hearing what you guys thought of them below. And if you have any other books you'd like to suggest for love and all of its obstacles, pop them down, because I would love to do another literary journey like this. It was a fun one. So as always, thank you for watching, and let's go read some books. Happy reading.